I'm going to respond to several of the claims one at a time. I have some important information you should know. The pagan copycat theory was refuted by scholars in the first half of the 20th century. More on this in a moment. He claims Horus is called the son of God. Cite a source for this. He was the son of Osiris, but he was not called the son of God, as your video claims. He was called many things, but not the son of God. The video claims Horus was born December 25th. This is irrelevant because Jesus probably wasn't born on December 25th. The earliest date celebrated by Christians was January 6th. Some Christians in the 200s believe Jesus was born May 20th. St. Constantine made December 25th the celebration of Jesus' birth to influence unbelievers. Some churches in the East still celebrate Jesus' birth on January 6th. He claims Horus was born of the Virgin Isis Mary. That is incorrect. Isis' Egyptian name is transliterated Aset, A-S-E-T. All female names in Egyptian end with a T. In fact, Isis was no virgin. She had sexual relations with Osiris and produced Horus. Horus was born in a swamp. The evidence is lacking that his birth was accompanied by a star in the east. The video claims three kings or magi followed Jesus' star. The New Testament never makes this claim. No number is given. So your point is irrelevant. The video claims Horus was a prodigal child at age 12. He wasn't a prodigal teacher. His mother hid him until he was to become ruler of Egypt. He claims Horus was baptized at age 50. Cite a source for this. He claims Horus was called the truth, the light, God's anointed son, the good shepherd, and the lamb of God. J.P. Holding did research into this and was only able to find these titles for Horus. Great God, chief of the powers, master of heaven, avenger of his father, since he avenged the one who killed Osiris. There is no evidence he died by crucifixion. One source says he was bitten by a snake. Another source says he died and was cast in pieces into the water. Here are some facts we now know about Horus which are dissimilar to Christ. Horus was not born of a virgin, was not a savior, had no communal meal of bread and wine, was not crucified, was not resurrected, did not ascend into heaven, and is not a divine judge. Lastly, the creator of the video I am responding to calls Jesus a mythical figure. This shows he is not abreast on modern scholarship. About 100% of contemporary New Testament scholars from a wide variety of theological perspectives, even atheists and liberals, have come to a consensus about Christ. One, he died by crucifixion. If he died by crucifixion, then obviously he is no myth. Two, he was buried by Joseph of Arimathea, and the majority of scholars today believe Jesus' tomb was found empty on Sunday morning. While most scholars today accept the historicity of Christ, almost nobody believes in the pagan parallel thesis anymore. The pagan parallel thesis was bandied about in the history of religion school of thought at the close of the 19th century and early part of the 20th century, but this thesis soon collapsed and has been virtually given up today among New Testament scholars. The parallels were spurious. Dying and rising gods did not concern historical figures. They were mythological symbols of the crop cycle. They did not concern resurrections. They existed in the afterlife. There is no causal connection between these myths and the Christian disciples. These myths were known among the Jews and they found them abhorrent. Scholars recognize that understanding Jesus is not paganism but the background of first century Palestinian Judaism. Traces of dying rising gods are not found in first century Palestine. They don't appear until the time of Hadrian. T.N.D. Mettinger, a Swedish scholar, professor at Lund University, member of the Royal Academy of Letters, History and Antiquities of Stockholm, wrote The Riddle of Resurrection, says that the consensus among modern scholars, nearly universal today, is that there were no dying and rising gods before Christianity. They all post-date the first century A.D. Dr. Ronald Nash, doctorate from Syracuse University, said scholars have refuted the pagan parallel thesis. See his book, Gospel in the Greeks, page 3. Adolf von Harnack says, we must reject the comparative mythology approach. See Reinventing Jesus, page 227. Robin Lane Fox of Oxford says that nearly all the supposed parallels between pagan practice and Christianity are spurious. See Pagans and Christians, page 22. Walter Kenneth criticized the idea of dependence and influence. See The Theology of the Resurrection, page 59. Not only has the pagan parallel copycat thesis been rejected by the majority of scholars today, but the thesis is also guilty of logical fallacies. I know of at least 4 fallacies committed by advocates of the copycat thesis. There may be more, but since I'm not a logician, I'm not qualified to say. The composite fallacy. This fallacy is committed when a person lumps mystery religions together. Lumping mystery religions together is the composite fallacy because one unified mystery religion never existed, and not in the first century AD. The dependency fallacy. This fallacy is committed when a person argues that Christianity borrowed not only the form but also the substance of mystery religions. The fallacy of false cause. Coincidence does not entail causal connection. The fallacy of suppressed information. This fallacy is committed when a person suppresses or hides information and data that refutes their thesis and arguments. Thank you for listening, and see the description box for more information.